You see how attractive Australia is. Any photo, if you stand in front of Opera House or Harbour Bridge, or even in a Botanic Garden, or even anywhere, our scenery is very beautiful.
It's like the view and the on the postcard is definitely one of the most attractive places in Australia.
See the opera, yeah. A nice view and nice sunshine. Yes, a great day, a perfect day.
One of my kind, when they come to see me, we are counting, I think within $150,000 is okay, but at the end we spend $500,000. How about if our seafood station put in the kitchen area? When the bride arrived in the room, come out, the big ceremony start at 4. So we want the guests to have a little bit of food, so that's why we want half an hour canapé.
Wedding planner Annie Lam specializes in the tough job of making other people happy.
Every day is paperwork, paperwork, paperwork. Seriously. You think about a wedding, you need to organize, make sure no mistake.
In recent years, Annie's wedding planning business in Sydney has seen an increase in demand from overseas clients.
Facebook, or like even Instagram, or even WeChat. All these people really say, oh my God, wow, my girlfriend get married in or have a ceremony in Australia, in Sydney. I also want it. Can I make it? Is it too expensive or is it possible?
Australia is now a popular wedding tourism destination for Chinese couples. Some fly over just to take pre-wedding photos in front of our most famous icons, but others have a stronger connection.
They were studying here before in Australia, maybe in Sydney, in Melbourne. They may go back to their own country. Then when they want to get married, they may think it will be so interesting. They can come back to Australia to have a ceremony or even a reception with some of their friends. Actually, it's increasing quite a lot. This one is also nice. Mm. You get the Harbour Beach, you know, the icon.
The biggest reason is we met in Australia, Sydney.
Mona and Daniel are about to get married. They studied and met in Australia, returned to China, but then decided to have their wedding back here. Maybe it has something to do with fond memories of their first date.
We have a lot to share, a lot to talk about, so I invited her to go to Jervis Bay. Yeah.
Which is a white sand beach. It's beautiful. Really like a heaven.
Mona and Daniel are bringing out friends and family from China for the big day.
I think the lifestyle of Sydney very different with in Hong Kong. And I want my brother and my best friends, some of them can come here to feel the difference.
And all this is good, not just for the happy wedding party, but the Australian tourism sector.
They come here not only come for a reception, a wedding. They are coming often for holiday. Like I would go to David Jones, oh, 3,000 address, it's okay, doesn't matter because I know I'm going to attend a very important, you know, reception or function. They will sightseeing. They may even go to Gold Coast, Tasmania, Melbourne, anywhere. They really is a group who have potential to spend the money, real money. Bridesmaid bouquet. Yeah, got some lot out here. And then that is the groom's buttonhole.
Mona and Daniel, with the help of Annie, have hired one of the most scenic venues for their big day.
It's a great sort of promotion for people who have never thought of coming to Australia. They see all these beautiful things, they might go back and then come back again for a proper visit.
The reception is a big hit with guests who've travelled here from China.
We have never visited Sydney actually. Yeah. It is our first time to be here.
Yeah, to join the party and then
it's so exciting.
Yeah.
I strongly recommend, you know, my friends, you know, even they're not living in Australia, to hold them to hold their wedding in Australia. Because in my opinion, it's the best place in the world.
So it's a quite a good income for the whole country, for Australia or for Sydney. Yeah, they may go to Melbourne or to the winery, but Sydney, come to Sydney. I don't think you will increase this one.